We're standing by for a coronavirus briefing from New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian. Here she is.
Good morning, everybody. Firstly, can I thank everyone for their cooperation over the long weekend, the Easter long weekend. Not only did we see the vast majority of people in New South Wales do the right thing, we also saw people still come forward and get tested, which was a positive because we made sure that medical services, both in testing and in other areas, were open over the Easter long weekend, and we're pleased that took place. As you'll see today, the number of cases emerging in New South Wales on a daily basis continues to decline, but we take that number with caution today, Dr. Chant will explain, because we did have slightly fewer tests on the Easter long weekend than we would have on a normal weekday. This week, our health officials will be ramping up testing, and I want to thank them because in New South Wales, we've almost conducted double the number of tests compared to the next state. So we know that our testing, the high regime of testing, but also of contact tracing, so once someone's tested positive, our ability to actually contact trace them and those that have been in contact with them is allowing us to control the spread, reduce the spread, and I want to thank everybody involved for that. Again, the rate of testing in New South Wales is really allowing us to control the spread, and that will obviously continue this week. And as Dr. Chant will outline, it will also continue in particular in areas where there's clusters, where we know there's a larger number of cases, either through a major event that took place in that area or because of community transmission. And Dr. Chant will outline those suburbs where we're really encouraging people to come forward and get tested. And we want to thank the community for really taking up that challenge. I also wanted to announce today in New South Wales a new service we have, which will allow people to get results on the same day if they're negative. So that is a huge step for us to make sure that people who are isolating because they think they might have the virus, they have a test, they'll be able to get a text, if they're happy for us to do that, on the same day to tell them that they're negative. Obviously, if you're positive, we need to contact you to see whether you need medical attention or also in relation to tracing your contacts. But if you're negative, there'll now be an SMS service available, and hopefully, if you're going through the public system, you'll get that result on the same day that you're tested. So that is a huge step forward in New South Wales, and in a couple of weeks' time that service will also be available through the Service New South Wales app. So last week I reported we had 1.6 people who downloaded the Service New South Wales app. This week it's 1.7 million people, so we know more people are getting on the app. We encourage that because not only does the app give you up-to-date information on what's happening with COVID, but it also prompts, if you're happy to, for us to send you texts on any new developments which occur. So from now on in New South Wales, you'll get same-day texts to say that you're negative. That will be a huge relief to you and your family, but also allow you not to be in self-isolation if that's what you've been doing, which is, again, a step forward. Again, I want to thank all of our health officials over the weekend who maintained the level of testing. I want to thank the community that came forward and also say that whilst we're encouraged by the reduction in the number of cases every day, it really is up to us to continue to follow the restrictions, to continue to do what we've been asked to make sure that spread is controlled. So I'll now ask Dr. Chant to give her update, then Commissioner Fuller, and then I'll ask Minister Dominello to give his update regarding Service New South Wales. But in addition to the great work the health officials did over the weekend, I also want to thank police. The Easter long weekend saw us release is probably the wrong word to use, about 3,000 people from quarantine in our hotels. So nearly 3,000 people that were previously quarantined as overseas travellers were allowed to go out and go home, which is a huge relief for them, but also a huge relief for us in terms of making sure they were well taken care of during that time. Dr. Chant.
Thank you, Premier. So as the Premier has indicated, we've had 7 new cases and that brings our confirmed cases to 2,870. Pleasingly, testing was maintained at some level over the weekend, but we do want to see these upcoming weeks having high rates of testing. The areas we'd like to focus on for this week are Penrith, Inner West, Liverpool, Randwick, Waverley, Wollara, Blacktown, Cumberland, Westmead, Ryde, Manning and Lake Macquarie. And that's because in those areas we have identified cases of COVID-19 where there aren't clear links to clusters, and so we want to assure ourselves that there is not broader community transmission occurring in those areas. So I would urge everyone in those areas to either call their GP or presented a COVID-19 clinic or their ED, depending on their situation, to undergo testing. And we will be relaxing any criterion in those areas so we can rapidly increase testing numbers to get a good sense of how we're travelling in terms of community transmission more broadly. There has been 26 deaths in New South Wales, so there were no deaths reported in the past 24 hours. And there's currently 225 people being treated by New South Wales Health, including 32 patients in ICU, and 19 of those are ventilated.
Well, good morning. Well, by close of business today, we would have seen nearly 7,000 Australians come back into Sydney International Airport, and also, thankfully, some 3,000 returned home safely. We're expecting around 100 international visitors to Sydney today, and that's down probably a third on what it was same time last week. So, you know, thankfully, in terms of those Australians in hotel accommodation and isolation, that will continue to reduce every day. Police issued another 55 tickets in relation to failing to isolate overnight. But again, we are seeing high levels of compliance up and down those coastal areas that would normally be busy with holiday makers. So I thank all the people of New South Wales for coming on that journey. But it is important, although it is school holidays, that people understand that the isolation restrictions are still in place and those health orders stand. Many of the tickets issued are people who had been given multiple warnings in the past, and police will continue to show the highest levels of discretion they can in these challenging times. In terms of the Ruby Princess, we took a male crew member off last night with an appendicitis, and again, as I've said, we will continue to take off anyone who needs urgent medical treatment or the type of treatment that can't be provided on the vessel. Thank you.
OK, we'll leave that press conference there for the moment. But as we saw in Queensland earlier with the Queensland Premier, the numbers have been steadily decreasing, even though there are fewer tests done over the weekend. Those numbers are still tracking in the right direction for a flattening of the curve, as they say. So that's good news. Also, I think this is a very, very good progress in terms of the testing and getting results in the on the same day. That'll alleviate a lot of the pressure on the system and also a lot of the anxiety, I think, in the community. So they're focusing in on a couple of those suburbs. But results in the same day, I think, will help the community a great deal.